Class 10, pay attention towards the board. Yes, all the chapters will be there, na, in first, you can say semester. Yes, so for today we are going to revise the chapter, Letter to God. So what the Letter to God chapter is about a farmer named Lanchu. Where he was living? Living on a, on the crest of a hill, and his house was the only one in the valley. Okay, how, what kind of man he was? Hardworking. Okay, working like an ox. Right? He's always working like an ox in the fields, right? So he is a good predictor of weather also. As he knew that the northeast wind will bring rain. Okay, and he had firm, staunch belief in God. Right? So what he had? He had firm and staunch belief in God. So what happened to him? What was his problem? That his field or his entire corn crop was destroyed. So in the light of now, what happened? This we have already read. Okay, so let us revise it. So what this story, Letter to God, is about? Letter to God is a story about a farmer who was living on the crest of a lonely hill where his house was the only house in the entire valley. Okay, so he is living there and he has grown corn field or corn crop in the field. He was expecting a good harvest, a healthy harvest from it. But what he was thinking, he was expecting only a downpour, you can say a pour of rain, in order to make its corn crop bloom into flowers so that he can reap a rich harvest. Okay, so in his family, there was his wife, his sons, the elder ones, they are working in the fields, and his younger sons were playing outside the house, okay, outside the hut, which is a small cottage. So Lanchu, he was expecting rain. He was just looking towards the sky with intending eyes that the north wind will blow and bring rain down to the earth. He was feeling that soon the rain will fill his fields, and his entire field, it will be filled with flowers, and it will bloom into a healthy harvest. So when the northeast wind started blowing, he thought that it will definitely bring rain. Of course, it happened. The rain drops started falling to the ground and ultimately onto the corn field of Lanchu, and he thought that these are not raindrops. What were they? What he has compared his corn fields to? He has compared the raindrop falling on the cornfield to that of what? To that of coins. Larger drops as 10 pice coin and the smaller one as 5 pice coins. Okay, so he has compared. But soon, what happened? That this downpour, it has changed into hailstorm. And the hailstorm soon, it was covering the entire field. The complete field, it was covered with what? It was covered with white layer of snow. And not, it has not left, or it has caused much destruction to the field of Lanchu. So what destruction it has caused? He has what? Okay. Before that, let me tell you that what he has compared these hailstorms to that of silver coins. But he had not known that this, you can say that this fall of hailstorm would cause much, you can say which would cause much destruction to his corn field. So what destruction it has produced? Not a leaf was left on the fields, and not even a single frog was stood alive and straight onto the ground. Okay. So what happened ultimately? His crop was entirely destroyed. And what he has compared the destruction caused to his cornfield to that of the plague of locusts. What comparison he has made? He thought that even if the crop would be inflicted with plague of locusts, it would have left more than that. But this storm of hail, it has not left anything onto the, field. So his entire field was destroyed. He did not have anything to survive throughout the year. So there was no hope for him. There was just one hope in front of him. And what was that hope? It was his firm belief, his staunch faith, his unshakable faith in God. He thought and thought throughout the night. And ultimately, he came to the point that there is no help that he would gain in this kind of storm or this kind of crisis, and that help would arrive only from God. Even his wife said that God would never let any being devoid of food anytime. So they said that they have only help of God. So in order to seek help from God, so what he has thought, that on Sunday morning, he has gone to the post office and he has written a letter to God. So what he has written in the letter to God? Why he needed 100 rupees? To grow what? Why he needed 100 rupees? He has written in his letter that what? Yes, he has written that he needed 100 pesos. Why he needed? In order to grow cornfield again and to survive throughout the year, that money would be enough. And with this, his firm belief, he has affixed the stamp onto the envelope and posted the letter into the letter box. And finally, this letter, it has been brought to the desk of the postman. So what kind of man was postman? He was fat, amiable, kind person. What was his reaction when he first seen the letter? What was his first reaction? He broke out into laughter. Okay. He broke out into laughter when he has seen letter in front of him, which was for God only. So at first he laughed, but suddenly what happened? Serious wave of expression, it covered his face. So he was deeply moved. So much impressed by the kind of belief this man is having in God, because he knew that the man who has written this letter to God, he must have firm belief that the help would definitely arrive to him back. Okay. That help will definitely arrive him back. Okay. So what happened ultimately? So he thought that this letter need interest to be paid. So for that, what he has thought, he read the letter and he found that Lencho has demanded for 100 pesos. As he was not able to collect those 100 pesos, so what he did, he also took the help of his colleagues. Okay. He also sacrificed a part of his salary and collected some money from his colleagues. And it turned out to be little more than half. So let us suppose that it comes out to be 70 pesos. Okay. So what it comes out to be? It comes out to be 70 pesos. Okay. So finally, with a hopeful mind, what he did, he put the money into the envelope and address the envelope from God. So why he addressed the envelope not with his name but with the name of God? Why he did not write his name? Because God has not sent that money. It was the postman who has sent the money. Why he has sent? Yes, it is because of the reason that he never wanted his faith to be shaken. He wanted that this faith should be maintained. Okay, his faith should be maintained. Okay, so then what happened? Yes, so this letter arrived to Lencho. Lencho, he was hopeful, and he with his expecting nature, he was coming to the post office in order to ask for the reply. And when he has got this reply, he, without showing any, you can say, surprise on his face. Why he did not show any surprise on his face? Because he knew that the help would definitely arrive to him, because he had firm, staunch belief in God. He knew that the help would definitely arrive, and it arrived to him also. And how it arrived? In the form of letter, including 100 pesos. He was expecting that it would contain how much money? It would contain 100 pesos, right? But what happened? But it was not 100 pesos. When he counted the money, it came out only be 70 pesos. And what kind of reaction he has shown with that? He was angry. So with his puckered brow and as well as with his folded brow, he angrily came to the post office window, asked for an envelope, and he immediately, you can say, put his hand hardly and strongly onto the desk, and he started writing a reply to God. So what he has written in the letter, that I asked for 100 pesos, but ultimately what has received by me, I received only 70 pesos, and those 30 pesos they have been kept by those post office employees. And with his puckered brow, with his angry look, he licked the stamp and affixed it onto the envelope and posted again. Okay, and the postmaster who has not handed over this letter directly to Lencho, he was standing behind in order to see the kind of expression the man would get after receiving the letter. Okay, so ultimately what happened, when he saw his angry look, he came to know that the man was not satisfied. So Lencho, when he has got those 70 pesos, he was not at all satisfied. So what he said, he thought that the post office employees were actually what? They were bunch of crooks who has taken his 30 pesos and demanded God to send the rest of the money. But he was thankless, of course, because he did not know that this money was sent by post office employees only, and ultimately he was not able to recognize the goodness in their character. So this is all about letter to God. What this letter is about? Letter to God is about a letter to God in which he demanded some money. And what this letter shows, it shows his firm, unshakable, okay, belief in God. Yes? Yes, this is the chapter. Let me ask you some questions. What was the raindrops compared to and why? Chapter first. No, afterwards. Stop there, I said. What was the raindrops compared to and why? Yes, the raindrops were compared to that of what? They were compared to that of new coins. The big drops, they were 10 cent pieces, and the smaller ones as 5 cent pieces, right? It's really getting bad now. What was getting bad now and how? It's really getting bad because the rain or the downpour, it is changing into hailstorm. What it is happening, that it is changing to hailstorm. And he knew that this hailstorm would bring lot of destruction to his field. What destruction was caused to his fields? What destruction was caused to his fields? His crop, corn crop, was entirely destroyed. Not a single leaf was left onto the crop. The flowers were gone also. And Lencho, what kind of feeling Lencho had after looking at the condition of the field? That he turned sad. Okay, he was filled with sadness. And where he stood, he sat in the middle of his field. And what comment he has made at that time? What comment he has made at that time? That the corn crop, that plague of locusts would have left more than that. When he has seen that, you can say destroyed corn crop, what expression, what comparison he has made? He has made the comparison to that of plague of locusts, that the plague of locusts would have left more than this, right? So, why was Lencho's soul filled with sorrow? Why was Lencho's soul filled with sorrow? Why was Lencho's soul filled with sorrow? Speak in English. Why was Lencho's soul filled with sorrow? Lencho's soul was filled with sorrow to see the kind of destruction that has been produced onto his corn field, because all the flowers were gone. All the flowers were gone. Not a single leaf was left onto the crops. And he knew that his entire crop has been destructed. So this is the reason. Everything will come up, will come to an end in this manner. And he would not reap a rich harvest. So it is because of this reason he thought that he was filled with sorrow. Okay. Why was the family not really upset? But the family, especially his wife, was not really upset. Why? Why his family was not really upset? His family was not really upset because they knew they were hopeful of their help from God. They knew that God will never let them die of hunger, because to those and to whom God has given birth, then what happened? They will never let them die of hunger. God will come and definitely help them, because when there is no hope, there is one hope, that is of God. That is of God. But what Lencho thought, he thought that they will all go hungry this year, but family was not thinking in this manner. Next is, why did the postmaster send a reply to Lencho's first letter addressed to God? So why did the postmaster thought that he should send a reply to his letter to God? Yes, because he knew that this man has unshakable belief in God, which he has never witnessed in his entire career. He has never seen any letter addressed to God. So this is the reason why he wanted that this firm belief, it need not to be broken and it must be maintained. It is for this reason he thought that he must address this, or he must reply this letter to God. Why was Lencho angry to receive the letter? Why was Lencho angry to receive the letter? Because he thought that, yes, because he thought that he has asked for 100 pesos for help, so that why he needed those 100 pesos? But why he ordered for 100 pesos? so that he could sow his crop again and would survive throughout the year. This is the reason why he asked for 100 pesos from God. But ultimately, when the help arrived, what it was? Only 70 pesos. Okay? It was only 70 pesos. So it is just because of this reason, when he has opened the letter and he has seen those 70 pesos, which were 30 pesos less than 100 pesos. So he was deeply in, or he was much in anger. And this anger was clearly displayed on his face in the form of his puckered brow. Okay, forehead. Next question. Do you think the post office employees were really a bunch of crooks? They were, who asked, who said that they were a bunch of crooks? Lencho has said that they were a bunch of crooks. But do you think that they were really a bunch of crooks? No. How will you justify it? How can we say that they were a bunch of crooks? They were not at all a bunch of crooks. Why? Because the post office, the postmaster, he himself has sacrificed a part of his salary and he has sacrificed a part of his salary and yes, and he also asked money from his colleagues in order to make it out to be 100 pesos. But it was his incapability that he was not able to come out with the desired amount as asked by Lencho, and he has come out with only 70 pesos. So this is the reason they were not at all bunch of crooks. They were actually the helping hands. This was the only, you can say, force behind, that was the only drive behind the help that has been arrived from God. And it was wrongly interpreted by Lencho that they were bunch of crooks. They were not at all bunch of crooks. Okay, so the next question is, how would you describe Lencho? So what are the qualities? What kind of man was he? Kind-hearted, kind-hearted. How you can say that he was kind-hearted? What kind-hearted act you have seen? No. Simple man. Hard-working man, working like an ox in his fields. Okay, have firm belief in God. Okay, you can say sometimes got depressed easily when he has seen the destruction of his corn field. He thought that locusts would have left more than that. Okay. Staunch, I have written here. Staunch, strong, firm, unshakable. Staunch, very strong. It means very strong. Okay, next. What was Lencho's feeling when the hail stopped? What was Lencho's feeling when the hail stopped? Yes, Raghav. What was Lencho's feeling when the hail stopped? He was sad. Okay. He was filled with sorrow. His soul was filled with sorrow. He was not angry. You can't say he was angry. He was sorrow. He was filled with sorrow only. Sad. Because all the flowers had gone, all the leaves, they have been shed apart from the stalks of the you can say of the plant, and his entire corn crop has been destroyed, and he has lost all the hope that his crop would reap him a good harvest. Next, what was Lencho's pride and possession? What was his pride and possession? What was Lencho's pride and possession? It was his corn field and his strong belief in God. Okay, strong belief. Yes, now you are clear with this, okay? So that's all for this chapter, Lencho. And let me tell you that you will have MCQ type question paper. No doubt, OMR sheet will be given. Okay, limited time will also be there. Don't expect, that will depend when papers will be formulated. So, and ultimately, don't expect 3 hours. Okay, 90 minutes like that. For example, it is mentioned, it is like you can say, for example, for every question, just less than half, less than 1 minute. Aise hi hota hai. One mark. Okay, 40 questions will be there, most probably. And 10 marks you will have for internal assessment. Yes, internal assessment. And your final result will be compiled of this first part as well as the second term. Okay, so complete, it will form 10 marks internal assessment here and 10 marks there. Your internal assessment will include your listening skill and your holidays homework, which we have given. Okay, and your notebooks also. I will formulate one and I will send. Okay, you will send by filling the Google form, right? Okay, and so I don't think so that you should lose those 10 marks. I feel that everyone should get 10 marks by submitting the work. Now, you got Keshav?
Yes.
Okay, so submit your work, holidays, homework, those who have submitted, well and good. Yeah? When you will submit the work only, then it will be given. Yes, I have noted down for that also. So online students, if you have any doubt, you can raise up your hand also. Yes, and questions. It depends now. I can't give any statement right now. 40 questions maximum. Maybe. Guidelines I'm not going to give. Okay. Right. So that's all for today. And if you have any doubt, you can ask me now.